This video we see the significance of chemical equations. Chemical equation provides both the qualitative and quantitative details about a chemical change or a chemical reaction. Qualitative means gunatmak and quantitative means matratmak. Means we can say that a chemical equations gives the knowledge of qualitative and quantitative details. We see here qualitatively means a chemical change, a chemical equations tells about the names of various reactants and products. In this equation, CaCO3 reacts with HCl to form CaCl2, H2O and CO2. Qualitatively, this reaction tells about the name. CaCO3 represents calcium carbonate, HCl represents hydrochloric acid, CaCl2 represents calcium chloride, H2O represents water and CO2 represents carbon dioxide in both reactants and product side. So a chemical equation in this represent or gives qualitatively the names of compounds present in the reactants and product sides. Quantitatively, a chemical equation provides information regarding the relative number of reactants and product molecules involved in the reaction. Means a chemical equation gives the knowledge how many molecules or atoms take part in a chemical reaction. The relative number of moles of reactants and products. This is the follow by first point. How many molecules of reactant and products react together to form a new substance, and what is the number of moles that are formed after the chemical reaction. Third number, the relative amounts by weight of reactants and product. Means what is the mass of reactants or what mass of reactants react with each other to form products, and then what is the mass of product formed during or after the chemical reaction. This information is given by chemical equation. This is the significance of chemical equation, by which we know the weight or mass of reactants and products. What mass of reactant react together to give how, or what mass of product obtained. Next, the relative volume of gaseous reactants and products. In this point, we know that according to a chemical equation, by the significance of chemical equation, this provide us what volume of gas reacts with each other to form a new volume of gas after a chemical reaction. We see these all points with an example now. In class 9, we read the molecular weight, and now we use here. In this example, CaCO3 reacts with HCl to form CaCl2, H2O and CO2. In this reaction, we see here 100 gram of calcium carbonate reacts with 73 gram of HCl to produce 111 gram calcium chloride, 18 gram water and 44 gram CO2. Total mass or weight in reactant side is 173 gram, and in also in product side 173 gram. This equation gives us the knowledge about calcium carbonate, HCl, CaCl2, H2O and CO2. Means this equation provides us the knowledge of these all compounds take part in a chemical reaction and form during or after a chemical reaction. According to this equation, we know that 100 gram calcium carbonate reacts with 73 gram HCl to give 111 gram CaCl2, 18 gram water and 44 gram CO2. Other information is, one molecule of calcium carbonate reacts with two molecule of HCl to give one molecule of CaCl2, one molecule of H2O and one molecule of CO2. This information is given to us by a significance, under the significance of chemical equation. Also see here, one mole of CaCO3 reacts with two mole of HCl to give one mole of CaCl2, one mole of H2O and one mole of CO2. But here we see the limitation of chemical equations. A chemical equation fails to provide the following information. In one hand, chemical equations provide us so many information, but in another hand, a chemical equation fails to provide the following information. Actual concentration of the reactants and products does not given by a chemical equation, and also time taken for the completion of the chemical change also not explained or given, not explained or obtained by a chemical equation. These are two major points that are not explained by the chemical equation.